people can
are both.
Can enjoy us just setting up and everything.
I am concerned about how many elites we're gonna have today.
Yeah, who knows if this will work.
I don't know. I'm kind of excited about my new character guy, though.
What's the icon?
I was reading about him.
What's the icon for your character?
It's the brain. Sorry, I have peanut butter in my teeth. For anybody watching, that's none of you, but apologies. I'm going to make weird faces for a minute. Yep, that guy.
We have decided, for our viewers out there, all zero of you, the last time Melissa and I met, we decided that maybe to make this one easier would be to have more characters. And so each of us are going to control two characters today. We'll see how it goes. I've got the Spellweaver in addition to the Sunkeeper, and Melissa has, what is it, Mind Thief?
Mind Thief, yep. And Mind Summoner.
In addition, there's a Mind Thief in addition to the Summoner.
The Mind Thief is a Vermling, so he is very scruffy.
Okay, I have to.
And I'm playing for anybody, so for Matt mostly, I'm playing the Mind Thief more as a enemy control rather than a summoner, because it can be played as like a baby summoner. Yeah, yours is big and like crazy looking. Is that supposed to be like fire coming out of her hands or?
No, yeah.
I couldn't fire tell. Either that or wigs. She's waving wigs around.
They're pom-poms. Yeah, they're scalps that she's waving around as pom-poms.
That's way darker than what I was thinking. So yeah, we're gonna see how this goes. We've added some melee capabilities and some big damage capabilities, but this may take way longer because we have to make two decisions every round instead of just one decision every round.
Yeah.
So
see how this goes. Okay, so all right. Do you think, okay, we were defeated last time. We did not succeed. So we scampered back to town.
Mm-hmm.
And that means we may do a city event if we want to, but we must do a road event.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we scampered back to town and like found some mercenaries in the bar and said, hey, need your help to get this guy out of here.
Right.
He's been dead two times, but I'm sure he's resurrected by the time we get back.
Yeah. So I'm going to pull up a city event.
Okay. Oh, are we going to give them retirement, our new characters' retirement things?
Sure. Let me get that deck out.
So they're like legitimate characters. There are our Moonlighter characters. Are you kidding me, low battery? All right, I got to go grab a cord. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Stupid low battery.
There, have some battery.
When someone has a retirement card, does that take it out of the deck for other characters?
Yes.
What about our previous characters who succeeded in the retirements? Are those put back in the deck or are they gone?
Those are back in the deck. I put them back in the deck anyway.
Okay,
I'll put not back in the deck. I put them like the other way around so I could tell which ones they were because they've been done.
Okay, I don't remember what your Tinkerer's retirement was, and it's in this deck right now.
It was Eternal Wanderer, if you want to pull it.
No. I did this wrong. Wait, maybe I did take him out.
You know what? I must be wrong. Oh, here it is. Yeah. Never mind.
Just in case we need to recruit these guys again, I feel like they're going to need retirement abilities.
Yeah. But yours, your current one is in this deck because I guess I forgot to flip it around. So I might accidentally pull it again. And if I do, then you just need to tell me. I won't look at it, but you need to tell me that I need to pull a different one.
Okay.
And it's draw two, pick one, right? Or is it just draw?
Yeah, you pick one. Mm-hmm. Whoa, what was that? Did they just, hold on. I think the kittens just did something really bad. The whole house shook.
It was an earthquake, right? The whole house?
Yeah, it felt like it was just our house. You guys go to the bathroom.
Life with kitten. I wonder how long the crouching is.
It was not the kittens. We don't know. Eric's going to look outside.
Okay.
Not sure what it was. It was like a big, I don't know if you could tell, but the whole house just went like boom. And earthquakes usually go boom and then bleh.
Yeah.
Okay. I got him. Oh. They were right next to each other in my deck.
Am I accidentally... So of the two that I'm looking at, one of them might be yours.
Yeah, and you can't show me.
All right. So.
Maybe you should show Eric. Eric, can you tell? Oh my gosh. So you still have to do it because I said so. I need you to look at Mark's cards and make sure neither of them is this one. So he's going to show you. I'm not going to look.
Nope.
Okay.
None of them are just that one?
This one.
That one? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Okay, we're all good. Thank you.
Jesus Christ. This one's mean.
I don't remember what we've opened. What's the icon for your... No, never mind. What's the... Okay, I think I can do this one. The other one I can do, but it's terrible.
I have a really evil one.
The one I have to look at. Hold on, I gotta. Oh. Neither of these is super doable. All right, I'm gonna try to do this. You can't look. I'm gonna try to do this one. And we'll see how that goes.
I didn't show the viewer which one I'm doing. Okay, viewer, I'm doing this one. Okay, city event number 7.
7, okay. Get that back together. Keeps being the early ones lately. Okay. Oh, we've done this one before. Walking along the edge of a forest, you begin to hear strange, unfamiliar sounds coming from beyond the trees. You stop and listen closer. There's a rhythm to the sounds, and with that established, you begin to pick, wait, road event or city event?
City.
Whoops. I was looking at the road event deck. Okay. Occasionally, your dealings in town lead you past the bustling docks. All conversation gets drowned out by the constant din of loading and unloading cargo and crew. This makes it all the more surprising when you hear a voice above the noise directed straight at you. Oi! You with the hard looks and big arms. I desperately need some help over here. Spare a few minutes to help make sure I get out of the port on time. Otherwise, I'll be stuck here until tomorrow. Option A, help the captain load his ship. Option B, move on with your business. You don't have time or inclination for such things. But you're a paladin, so we would definitely help him, right?
Let's help our fellow man.
What was advertised as a few minutes turns out to be an hour or two as you lug large crates full of some foul-smelling liquid from the nearby warehouse into the hold of the ship. At least the captain is relieved that he'll be able to set sail on time, though. He gratefully pays you, but you can't help but think that such menial labor might be beneath you. Gain 5 gold each. That's cool. But we lose 1 reputation. But we're at 20, so that's not a big deal.
Okay. And does it... get removed from the
Yep, it's a ripper.
Okay. 5 gold each.
Yeah, but we lost some reputation. Where's our party? Yeah. We're down to 19 reputation. Dude, I forgot about our price modifier.
Oh yeah.
I definitely paid full price when I created this character.
Me too. What is the modifier?
-5.
Per item?
Yep. So okay. I get 20 gold back. That's pretty sweet.
That is pretty sweet. Okay. So we went to town, went to a bar, recruited these two guys. Did some dock loading and then
lost some reputation, gained some gold, discovered that we paid full price.
Event number 2 on the road.
Okay. You are feeling a tad hungry as you walk down the road. You are considering stopping for a meal when you come across a thicket of bushes covered in green berries. The berries look delicious, but you hesitate. They could be poisonous. Option A, eat the berries. Option B, pass by the berries and just eat your normal rations. I'm sorry, green berries? No. That never ends well.
No. You have to identify them.
Yeah. We need a ranger to identify them for us. So option B, we're going to not eat those berries. Not wanting to regret making a stupid decision, you refrain from eating the berries and continue on down the road. No effect. Oh, we totally should have eaten the berries. Weird. It's funny how often they make it so that the obvious choice is the wrong choice.
Put it back in the deck.
Yeah, it's a back in the deck one. So okay. Next time there's berries, we eat the berries.
Okay.
I know I'm not supposed to look at the other half of the card, but it's really hard not to. We have to read all of the opening stuff for the slave pens again.
I don't think so. Read it
through now. Okay. Yeah. So in case any of you are watching, there's nobody, but if somebody's watching and they missed the last two versions of slave pens, you can go watch us read the book to you on one of the other slave pens ones. But essentially, we need an orchid to help us with something that Hale said, and we found that the Orchid Village has been taken over by Enochs and they turned them all into slaves. So we're trying to rescue them. And there's one in particular that we're trying to help who's stupid. He's very stupid. So we're gonna try again to bring him out alive. Now you're caught up.
Okay, we have two
Elite Warriors.
Mm-hmm. I thought it was just one Elite Warrior, and I was very sad when I saw your setup, and I was like, oh no, they are both Elite. There's a lot of Elites in this.
Okay, so where should we put our characters?
So here's the bad thing. Our two new characters only have 8 hit points each, whereas our other characters have lots more hit points. But my 8-point Mind Thief guy is a melee guy, so he needs to be up front. I was thinking he'd just be like front right. And I was, your spellcaster lady, I'm sure, should be in the back.
Yep.
And then your paladin in front of her.
Mm-hmm. Like that? Can you see that?
Yeah. And then my little guy, who's not actually a little guy. You still have my guy. I don't have my guy. Because the dog ate him. Her, the dog ate her. So sad.
Okay.
Okay.
This is going to take a while because we have to look at 2 hands now.
Yes, we do. Okay. I've got my summoner cards. I'm just gonna hold them in a deck like together. One giant set of things. Actually, I'll just do that.
Do you remember if last time we had to add cards to our modifier deck?
Oh, we had to add cards to our, I had to last time, but if you did a thing to the dungeon, the temple, then you get to add blessed cards. I did not give any money. We also forgot to do these things.
Oh yeah, okay. I have blessed cards in here. I think I did this. Let's see how this goes. Okay, here's 2 of them, I guess, for your first guy.
Okay.
And then 2 for your second guy.
Okay.
2 for my first guy. Ooh, that's not good.
Right. All right, I guess I'm gonna do this one for my first guy. And then I have to still look at my second guy. Okay, and then I'm going to do this for my second guy. So now I have goals.
Mm-hmm. And here's my first and second. First, second. Okay. Okay, I have my cards.
Me too.
I have 18 and 26.
I have which for which?
18 for the Sunkeeper and 26 for the Spellweaver.
Okay, I have 8 for the Mind Thief. And 92 for the Summoner.
Okay, they have 15. Jeez. Okay, your Mind Thief goes first.
Okay, so my Mind Thief gets a an augment, which adds plus two. Here, I'll show you. It adds plus two attack to all of my melee attacks. Oh wait, hold on. First, he moves up, and then. So that, and then he does that because I also get to attack one. So I get to attack three to, I don't know, the guy on the left.
Okay.
So on his left. So, oh, it's got retaliate too, crumb. All right, still. Let's pull a card. And I whiffed, so it doesn't matter because I whiffed. That was the worst turn ever. Well, I'm now augmented forever, so.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, I thought so too. Okay. And I gained an experience point, so.
These guys shield up. So now they have shield one. They both attack your guy with attack four and poison.
Oh, he's going to be dead already.
Terrible.
This is the worst.
Maybe you shouldn't have attacked him yet.
Maybe.
First guy draws a plus one, so that's five damage and poison.
He is so dead.
Second guy draws a zero, four damage and poison. He's dead already.
He's all the way dead.
You should lose some cards.
I only have 10. All right, I'm gonna lose that card for the first one.
You could take the second one if you want. You would have 4 hit points.
Yeah, I'll take the second one. All right, so he's down to 4. And he's poisoned.
Yep.
Dude, this is what I get for bringing a lower level character into this dungeon. All right.
I know, maybe this was a bad idea. We'll see.
We'll see. He can heal himself. He can't heal anybody else, but he can heal himself, so.
I thought I would be going first because I was going to shield up and everything and take all the hits, but that didn't happen.
I forgot to tell you, he's really speedy, like really speedy.
Okay, so I'm going to move forward.
Oh, I could have turned myself invisible and then I wouldn't have taken all those hits. I was saving it.
Ward one and shield up. So I got shield one. Then okay. attack five. But they have retaliate and shield one.
Mm-hmm.
5 plus 1 is 6 minus their 1 shield is 5 damage on this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then they hit me back 2 points.
But you have a shield, right?
Oh yeah, they hit me back. No, shield doesn't... I thought
oh,
shield
right.
do
it doesn't
talk.
Hit. Yeah.
So that's that Sunkeeper. The Spellweaver. Yeah. is gonna attack the same person.
Okay.
With an attack 3. Creates a sun icon. Oops. A sun whatever. Element or whatever to appear. And then mm-hmm. the attack 3, range 3. So attack 3. First whiff. And then the second action attacks again. Oh, wait. I don't shuffle yet, huh? Attacks again and an attack 2. Oh, wait. It's a range of 2. Shit. Not within range.
No.
I should be drinking alcohol.
It's way too early for me to start drinking alcohol. I have homework to do.
God damn it. The stupid range thing. I thought they would be closer by now, whatever. So I don't do anything. Oh, wait, I can move. I'm going to move forward one.
Okay. Yeah, because we need to block him. He's going to try to make a break for it. And we need him to not end up next to this guy. So
okay, I am done and it's now your turn.
Okay. How much does he move? He moves 3 every time. Yeah, we need to block him. Okay, so first I'm gonna move my summoner up 1, 2 into the space. Don't put it in the mind thief pile. And then I'm summoning my thorn shooter right behind me.
Like in the oh yeah. Like between your guys behind you?
Sure, between my guys works better because that blocks him a little bit better. Only a little bit better. He just won't, he'll move around the side. Yeah, and that's my turn. It's not an exciting turn, but it's better than my other guy who's
should I go in the middle like, or... move my guys towards the middle. Let's pretend I went there.
Okay.
Oh, you're out think, there.
Yeah, I might have already. Okay, so then this guy now moves 3. Which side does he go to, do you think?
I don't know. I think we get to decide. This way. Because if there are guys here, they can't shoot him through the door if he's
okay. True, very true. Okay, so he's like kind of between your guys?
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
All right, next round.
Oh, I forgot to put my guy in. 3. My thorn shooter.
Okay. So the goal is to kill everyone, right? Yep, geez.
Yep, the goal is to kill everyone. So essentially we need to just keep him blocked up. And as soon as we unblock things, somebody needs to go running forward and pull all the aggro.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try healing you.
You might not need to.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'm gonna attack people.
What? That's absurd. Okay.
All right. Geez. My Sunkeeper has 32 and my Spellweaver has 80.
Okay, my Mind Thief has 11 and my Summoner also has 32.
How do we determine who goes first?
Let's just go in the order that it shows on your screen.
Okay. Mind Thief first. But the enemies are going to move and attack and strengthen themselves.
Okay. So I'm going to heal two self. So that means that I'm just not poisoned anymore. I'm probably going to go invisible after this because I am afraid. because then I do two attacks, but they have retaliate, right?
Are you sure you don't want to heal?
Maybe I do want to heal. No, because the retaliate will kill me if I do it too badly. So I think I'm only going to attack once. Wait, what did I use on this one? All right, I'm doing an attack of two, but it's actually an attack of four on that same guy.
Huh?
Because I have that like plus two attack. So an attack of four on this guy, the same guy we've been whacking at. And I get plus zero, so four. And he hits me for two, I guess.
Uh-huh.
My dude is gonna die super fast.
Does he still have shield?
I don't think so, because they used the shields on the last turn. Right?
I guess so. Well, but maybe it's in effect until the beginning of your turn. Whatever.
I don't remember. We looked it up last week. Not 2 weeks ago, whatever week it was.
Yeah.
Oh, and I'm turning invisible.
Okay. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Yeah.
The Sunkeeper is gonna allow one adjacent ally to perform an attack four. So you're the that would be bad.
Yeah, get your Spellweaver to do the attack for. Or is it only melee?
It's only melee.
Crap.
You're damn retaliate. You only have two hit points?
I only have two hit points because I had to use the heal to get rid of the poison.
Okay, I'll use the other ability.
Weirdest character to play because he's meant to get in close and like stab people, but then he's got no hit points. He's level three and he's only got eight. Like, that's hardly anything.
Do you want to grab three of your discard cards or should I do my own person?
I have three cards in discard, which would be great because he's only got 10. He's only got one more than my summoner. So both of these guys are going to get exhausted if I'm not careful.
Okay, my Spellweaver only has eight.
Okay, so then use it on your Spellweaver. Don't use it on me because I have at least a couple more cards.
Okay, so I'm using this ability where the Spellweaver can grab these two cards and put it in your hand. And then I'm using this ability where I'm moving, but I'm not moving. But I am gonna stun this guy. So he's now stunned.
Cool. Stun.
And I get XP for that. Okay, now it is the summoner's turn.
Okay, so first my thorn shooter shoots at that same guy, I guess, for two and poison. Ooh. Stun and poison. Two stun and poison. So he's double stunned.
He and he's poisoned.
And he's down to one hit point.
Okay.
Okay. And then I am going to shoot at that same guy.
Wait, don't kill attack. Him.
Huh? Don't kill him?
No, because if you do, then the guy's going to run through the door.
Okay, never mind then. I'm attacking the other guy. wait a second. Nope, never mind. I thought my mind thief added an element that he didn't add. Okay, so I'm attacking the other guy for three and immobilize. So three minus one, so two and immobilize. So he can't move now. And then, oops, wrong discard pile. And then I'm also attacking him again for three with pierce, which doesn't really matter because he doesn't have a shield anymore, minus one. So again for two, same guy. So now he's down to eight and he's immobilized.
Okay.
That is my turn.
Okay, on their turn, this guy just becomes unstunned. And then the other guy doesn't see your mind thief and so attacks your summoner instead, right?
Summoner, yeah. Attack of what?
Attack of four. He strengthens himself later, afterwards.
Yeah, after, I think.
Four plus one, five.
Ugh, gross.
These guys are hard hitting.
They are hard hitting. Okay, it's fine. I still have 10 hit points on my summoner, but we're gonna have to like sit and have a long rest moment.
Okay, you're gonna hate what I'm doing.
I guess I need to decide what I'm doing.
My Spellweaver is gonna attack the guy who has 8 hit points. It's an attack of 3. Draws plus 1, so 4 points against the guy who has 8 hit points, so he has 4. And then he is, or she, I guess, jumping over to here to open this door. It'll make sense.
Okay. So now we gotta spawn those other guys though.
Yeah, that's true. That was probably a bad idea. Actually,
where are we spawning these guys? One like right there, blah. And then two down the hallway.
Two archers, right? Ooh, this is a bad idea. Oh wait, no, it's not that bad of an idea. Okay, so we'll do that and then potentially we'll be doing something else, but I wanna see what those guys are gonna be doing first. One and two. So archers, wait, are they archers or shaman?
They're archers. The shaman are in the next room. It's not gonna go well.
This stone dude.
We're gonna have to play a brute. I'm gonna have to like make a random brute. for whacking things with.
Okay, the stone dude is gonna not do anything, just retaliate three.
So nobody hit him.
Then the archers are gonna, they're gonna shoot target two.
Your thingy, your spellweaver is the only thing in range.
Yeah. So, okay. So my spellweaver is gonna activate the cloak of invisibility.
All of the invisibility cloaks have now been used, so we better hope we don't get later.
But okay, so now it's the stone golem's turn. He doesn't do anything. The archers' turn. They don't do anything. And now it is the next round.
Next round, finally. If we make it.
Oh wait, this guy. Oh, he tries to move, but he can't move anywhere. There's nowhere to move.
Yeah, there's nowhere to move. Good. I understood what you were doing once you did it, but he's just, I'm so concerned about him. I'm concerned about all of us. It's not gonna go well. I'm
concerned about, I agree.
This is like the most ridiculous. We're gonna have to cheat super badly if we're gonna beat this. I don't wanna play a brute. The stone golem has two shield, just as an aside.
Oh, great.
Oh, dude, Mind Thief. Did I have a heal that I did not pick? I did not. Okay. Man, there are a lot of lost cards on this character.
Do we need a heal?
I'm down to two.
Okay.
Because he's, you know, a melee character that's squishy. This is why I play ranged DPS. It's a lot harder to die if they can't reach you.
Okay, I've got D7 for my Sunkeeper and D6 for my Spellweaver.
Okay. I have 16 for my Mind Thief and 45 for my Summoner.
Okay. So it'll be your Mind Thief, then the guards, then the archers. They're just doing straight up attacks, all of them. Then Spellweaver, okay. Sunkeeper, and then the golem is attacking six, range three. Woohoo! Okay.
Okay, so my Mind Thief is going to attack that, whichever one is the one that only has one hit point. Which one is it? This guy. For three. And then strengthen himself. So he's going to attack, and that guy's poisoned. So for four plus zero, that guy's dead.
Yep. No retaliate because he's dead.
Because he is dead. Okay. And then, and I strengthened myself. What's strengthen do again? I've never played a melee guy.
You draw two cards. You have advantage.
Oh, I get advantage? Okay, cool. So then the other guy I'm going to attack for five. And I get advantage. So plus one or plus one. So I attack him for six. So he is also dead.
Wow. That's
Awesome. It ended. And that is my turn for the Mind Thief. I'm going to need to do a rest soon with him, but not yet.
Okay. The guards don't get to go because they're dead now. The I'm still invisible, right? Or not?
I think invisibility wears off at end of next turn. So you're still invisible, yes. Which means they're going to try to shoot my guys.
Yeah. They're not in range, though, so they have to move forward. They get to move. So, like, if this guy moves here, he can see the three of us, right?
He can see... Yeah, he can see all three of us. So he's going to shoot. He's going to kill my guy.
Yeah. The guy who moves there and shoots your guy. Attack of 4 plus 2, 6 points. Lose another card.
Losing another card. I'm going to lose this card, I guess. Bye-bye. So sad.
The other guy moves one space, I guess, two spaces, and you're not, no one's in the room.
They're all up here now. Mm-hmm. They're all like in a triangle now, yeah?
Yep, but he's not within range.
If we had some AoE, that would be good.
Yeah. The Spellweaver uses Freezing Nova. No, wait, the Spellweaver moves. This might be terrible. Moves here. And then uses Freezing Nova, which is an attack of 2, target all adjacent enemies. So those two guys.
Wait, where did you move? Like into the corner here?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So one of us needs to probably run up and fill that hole so that he can't get out.
Yeah, I plan on doing that.
Okay. I was just trying to decide if I needed to do it. Okay,
I mean,
I'm good.
You can if you want.
Either way. Okay, so what is the Spellweaver doing?
Prostanova, attack 2 on adjacent enemies, immobilize them. That's it. It's not that great. Okay, on the golem, is this how bad is this going to be? Golem has shield 2.
I need to get my wolves out because they have pierce.
Okay, anyways, draws a -1, does 0 points of damage on the golem, but the golem is immobilized.
Immobilized?
Uh-huh.
Okay, cool.
And then draws a +1 against the archer, so that's 3 points. And immobilize on the archer. Which archer is that one?
Okay.
And then that is it.
Okay.
And now it's your summoner's turn.
Okay. So first, my thorn shooter, 1, 2, 3, 4, yep, shoots the archer that's almost in the doorway for 2 and poison, for 1 and poison. So the archer in the doorway is poisoned as well as immobilized and has 1 more damage off. And then dang. So you were gonna run into the doorway?
I can.
You know what? I'm gonna move into the doorway, and then if you move just up one, then he will be stuck behind us basically.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna move two. One, two, wait. Never mind. First, I'm going to make one adjacent summoned ally perform a move one, attack one, plus a move plus one, attack plus one. So I get a thingy. So I'm not going to have him move. I'm just going to have him shoot that guy again for three and poison. So for four plus one, five. He just hit that guy for five. And then I'm moving up into the doorway. One, two. And that is my turn. And I'm going to need to take a rest for both of my guys after this next turn. I don't want to take a long rest, but long rest is apparently how you keep these guys going for longer. So I might have to take a long rest, but that is, would be a terrible idea. So we'll see. That's
probably a bad idea. Well, I don't know.
Actually, I might take a long rest on this next turn with my Mind Thief because he's kind of trapped behind everybody. He doesn't have a lot of range. Oh, wait. I just said that and nope, he doesn't have a lot of range stuff. So I might take a long rest on this next turn because he'll be kind of blocked. Okay. And that will deal with some health problems too.
How much damage does he have right now?
He's or
I heal, I heal him for three. I heal the Mind Thief for three.
Okay, thank you.
And I also generate a sun symbol at the same time.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna move. I think I'm moving. I'm not gonna stand right behind you. I'm gonna move over here.
Okay.
Just so that next turn I don't have to move and I can attack.
Okay.
But the stone golem goes next and it's going to shoot one of us for six.
Great. Is my mind thief in range?
He's got a range of three, so no.
Okay, phew.
The next person is a Spellweaver, so that's my guy.
At least you get an advantage, though, because you're right next to him.
Yeah, that's true. Or would he shoot your guy? Because then he wouldn't have disadvantage.
Oh, right. He would shoot my guy.
Okay, so he shoots your guy. Draws a minus one, 5 points of damage.
Ugh, my poor summoner.
But he himself loses two hit points.
This is going to be a really short. This is going to be so...
again another really short one.
Okay, my mind thief is taking a long rest this turn because he totally needs to.
Okay. Don't forget that when you take a little rest, you get hit points too.
Yeah. Actually, I'm going to long rest both of them because I don't have anything good to play right now on either of them. And they could both use the hit points and I still get my summon will still go. So we'll still get an attack out of it, but both of them will get to rest.
These cards suck.
Okay, I'm gonna get rid of that one. Give myself two more points. There we go. Oh, I also have a healing potion. I should probably use that when I get wacky again. And one, two. All right. Sorry for having to long rest.
It's okay.
Oh, wait, this guy didn't move. We didn't move him.
Oh, yeah. He moves too.
He's up behind me on the loot.
Uh-huh. Okay, so Jesus Christ. I guess I have 55 for my Sunkeeper. And
that's how I felt.
83 for my Spellweaver.
I already failed at one of my check marks.
Your mind at 99. What's your
also 99. I did two long rests.
What?
I told you that.
I thought you were only doing one guy.
No, I did both because I didn't have anything good in either hand to play, and my Thorn Shooter's still gonna shoot. So don't worry, my Thorn Shooter's still gonna do a thing.
Okay.
But I needed to get back. I had to. Sorry.
The archers. Is that guy still immobilized?
He's poisoned, but I'm not sure he's immobilized anymore.
I think he is because I immobilized him after he went, and then it's now he gets an
oh okay
and he so he loses that guy loses his immobilize but doesn't move, and he does an attack to range four. I guess attacking the Sunkeeper. Yeah. Attacking a Sunkeeper draws a plus one, so that's three on the Sunkeeper. And I'm using my chainmail.
So it's how many points?
2 points.
Okay.
And then the
other. Because I was the only one taking damage.
The other guy doesn't have to move and also shoots the Sunkeeper, draws a plus one, so that's two damage again. And that's two uses of the chainmail. So okay. I'm down 12.
Okay, so then you get to take a long rest next turn.
Then the stone golem is going to move and attack four, but doesn't need to move. Attacks the stone Sunkeeper also. Oh, and he loses his immobilize. He draws a plus zero, so he does 4 points of damage to the Sunkeeper. And that's the third use of the chain. So I'm down to 9. Because he
don't
actually
you have
did.
A shield?
What?
Don't you have a shield?
Yeah, well, I have this chainmail.
I thought you were also shielded.
That was only for one turn.
Oh.
And then I have another ability where I am shielded forever, but it's a discard one. I mean, it's a use up the card one. And it's a minus one movement for the rest of the game.
Oh yeah, and we don't want that for this.
Yeah, last
this
time match. That sucked, and so I didn't do it. Okay, that wasn't that bad. Sunkeeper took hits. Sunkeeper's turn is gonna, she's gonna use healing potion and go back up to 14.
Sweet.
And then should I attack the golem with a 5 attack, or should I attack the golem with a 2 attack and stun?
I think 2 attack and stun, because the golem hits hard.
Yeah.
And that gives us another turn to whack it.
Okay, so attacks the golem with a 2 attack and stun. So the 2 plus 2.
Sweet.
4 and stun. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, wait, but he has shield 2, so it's actually only 2 points. But it is stunned.
Stunned is good.
And then I'm nothing good here. I'm gonna move here onto the loot just so I can grab the loot.
You move back to grab the loot?
No, that's dumb. I'm not gonna do that. I will not do anything with for my movement. I'm just gonna, I'll do a little jig.
Okay.
And the spell.
Okay. I said, was that the Sunkeeper?
Yeah, that was the Sunkeeper. The Spellweaver yeah. I'm at disadvantage at these guys. Let's see. This guy, how many hit points? Just 2, huh?
Mm-hmm.
But if I kill him, then our little NPC guy is going to run out.
Oh, yeah.
So I guess I'm going to attack the other archer who hasn't been hit yet.
Okay.
So an attack of 3. Minus 2, jeez, 1 point. And I refreshed the sun icon.
Okay, so here's the thing. My thorn shooter would totally kill that guy that we don't want dead.
Oh. Right. Well, I don't know if that can be helped.
Yeah.
I'm moving this guy here to grab this loot because
okay.
It'll be helped. The NPC is running out.
Okay. Yeah, the NPC is totally running out. How are we gonna get ahead of
him? Hmm?
How are we gonna get ahead of him?
I don't know. It's
okay.
A little better. Anyways, your thorn shooter
hit on him. So my thorn shooter would shoot this guy for 2 and poison, and he's already poisoned. So for 3 and poison, plus 1 for 4 and poison, he's dead.
Yeah.
And there's nothing else I can do about that.
Okay, then this guy runs out. 1, 2, 3 to there.
Yeah.
And then you do all your long resting and all that stuff. And
do I have any sweetness? I gotta play that. Oh, this is interesting. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna do that, and it's gonna be ridiculous. But it's gotta work.
I'm not gonna do long rests.
I've been using the same deck for everything, which I shouldn't be doing because this should be just for this guy and this should be for everybody else. And I've been using this deck the whole time. All right, we're gonna try to remember to use different decks now. That's terrible.
Okay, my Sunkeeper has 23. Oops, next round. And then my Spellweaver has. I guess 69.
Okay, my Mind Thief has 48. And my Summoner has 82. And we all gonna die.
Yeah. All right, Sunkeeper first.
Okay.
The Stone Golem's not going to do anything because he's stunned. So that's good.
Sweet.
Okay, Sunkeeper. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. He will move two spaces, or she, onto this loot here. And then attack the archer. With an attack of 5. 5 heals for 1 point. 5 plus 0 is 5. Anything special about this guy? Nope, just 5 points straight up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I haven't poisoned that guy yet.
Nope. Okay, Mind Thief turn.
All right, I'm replaying my augment. I can't attack anything, so I don't get that one thing, but at least I've got my augment back. And then I force one enemy within range 5 to perform attack 2, targeting another enemy with me controlling the action. Ooh. So who do we want? Do we want the Stone Golem to hit the archer?
Can he? He's stunned.
He is stunned. All right. So, but the archer is not going to do super well because the archer is
at disadvantage.
At disadvantage. No, because it's a melee.
Oh, okay.
The archer's disadvantage, but
the Stone Golem has a shield too.
Yeah.
Control them even if they're stunned.
Yeah, that's what I think. So I think the Stone Golem tries to hit the archer. Can you draw a card?
Hmm? Oh.
Can you draw a card for him?
Or yeah. No? Whiffs.
Are you kidding me? Okay, well, that's my Mind Thief turn.
Okay. Like,
worst turn ever. Again, this is just terrible.
The Stone Golem loses the stun, and now the archer goes. Attack 4, range 5. It's gonna shoot. I think it's gonna shoot the Mind Thief.
Oh, really?
Because you're within range.
Yeah, that's true.
And would be at disadvantage. So minus one. So attack of, so 3 points.
All right, that's fine.
Okay. Spellweaver. Weaver. Will heal you for 3 points.
Which me?
The one that needs it the most.
I'm gonna say Mind Thief. For how many points? Three?
Three, yeah. Wow. And then it's just gonna move one space to grab this loot.
Okay. Boink.
I think that's it. Yes, that's it.
Okay. So now the summoner gets to go. And oh wait. First the thorn shooter gets to go. It moves up one so that wait a second. Yeah, it moves up one and shoots this archer for two and poison. Let's use the correct deck. For three and poison. So that archer is now poisoned and down to 2 hit points.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm doing something crazy. I'm moving 1, 2, 3, 4 into the doorway to get ahead of this guy. What's in this next room that's gonna make us super sad?
Lots of guys. Oh, Jesus. 2 stone golems.
One guy there. One guy. Oh my gosh, 3 shaman? Oh no, 3 guards? 3 guards. And a shaman.
At least they're not elite.
Yeah, but there's 4 of them and then 2 elite golems. This is a hot mess. And then I'm going to 1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh, there's no way for me to block him. He's coming in no matter what I do.
Coming in hot.
All right, well, I'm going to summon 2 shadow wolves to block as much space as possible. Which way do we want him to go? Not towards the golems. So I'm going to put 1 there and 1 there. All right, I need to spawn all these dudes.
Wait, okay, so you moved... You're still in the middle of your turn, right?
I just finished my turn by spawning the wolf guys.
Oh, where are the wolves now? In front of you?
Hmm?
Where are the wolves?
One directly in front of me and 1 on the side of the golems.
Okay.
2 and 6.
Oh, and so... The concern is that this NPC is still going to run through the door and be right there, right?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah.
But before he gets to do that, we have to move all these guys.
Yep. I was trying to block him and it did not work. And my shadow wolves are probably going to die almost immediately because these guys have to move.
Mm-hmm.
So general fail.
The shaman's going to move 2 and heal 3 range 3. He won't be able to get within range, but he does try to move forward, right? Like he attempts to get within range.
And heal me.
He'll go there like next to your 2 wolves and then not do anything. Yeah. And then no, the guards.
Would he move because he's healing? Oh, yeah. Is he trying to heal guys? Okay, I see.
So, mm-hmm. So then the guards, what order do I have them in here? So this guy, this guard, attacks this wolf.
Mm-hmm.
He draws a -1. So 2 points on that wolf.
Okay. Oh, I forgot to spawn the wolves. Okay, that wolf is still alive, but barely.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna switch these guys. 5 is there and 6 is there. So 5 is gonna move forward 1 and attack the same wolf.
Okay.
Draws a -1, so 2 points.
So that wolf is now dead.
That wolfie's dead.
Dead. Bye bye, Wolfie. So now he's just gonna walk straight into the bad guys.
Yes, he is. this guard moves to, but doesn't get to attack any of us. Where's he gonna go? I think we'll move here next to the terrain thing, the rubble or whatever.
The stump? Wait.
Yeah.
Behind the shaman?
Yep.
Okay.
And then the golems get to go.
Bye bye, other wolfie.
So this guy here, actually, I'm going to switch these so I can do them in order. This guy is going to move and attack. Yeesh. Move 1, attack the wolf for 5, -2, 3 points.
Wolf is dead.
Wolf only has 3 points?
Yep.
Man,
it's not you need to defend
these summons.
I can beef up their hit points, but really they're meant to be fast. They're meant to be fast, squishy melee attackers like the Mind Thief.
The other golem's just moving two spaces forward.
Okay. And now this guy is running out in front of everybody else, and
yeah, about and he to runs right there. Oh, geez. Was that your plan?
That was not my plan at all. It was a bad plan. Well, I wasn't thinking about the fact that there's like way more bad guys this time around. I was like, oh, there was only like 3 guys in there last time. I can totally like plop my wolves down and he can't get through.
Yeah.
Then they killed my wolves.
Next round, and my Spellweaver is taking a long rest.
Okie dokie.
And then the Sunkeeper is taking a short rest. So I need to do that. It's not a terrible, terrible card to lose, I guess.
We're about to lose. I think we should just pick the guy up next time and take him out the back.
Yeah.
This experiment did not work.
No, it didn't. It really didn't.
Maybe we should go with the other thought we had, which is to just make it one level easier.
Yeah, that's probably better. Anyways, my Sunkeeper has 57.
You said the Spellweaver is taking a long rest, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, and Sunkeeper is 57. The Mind Thief is 9, and my Summoner is 55.
Okay, man, the Shaman has 8.
Oh, man.
Gonna move 1, attack 2, range 3, immobilize. Does not need a move. Wait, yeah, doesn't need a move. Yeah. Range 3, so shoots the NPC or shoots you?
Shoots me because the NPC is right next to it.
Oh, yeah, you're right. And immobilizes you. Draws a minus 1. So you take 1 damage and you are immobilized.
Okay. I'm all and right with that.
Now the Mind Thief.
Okay, the Mind Thief is moving 3, I guess. 1, 2, 3. And attacking for 2, the Stone Golem, I guess. Where did I go? I'm up here. Attacking the Stone Golem for 2, but plus 2, so for 4. Times 2, so for 8.
Ooh.
Which one is that? 8. Oh, wait, but there's two shields.
He has 2 shields. Six.
Okay.
3, 4, 5, 6. So he has 4 left, right?
Yes. Okay, but then I'm attacking him for 3 plus 0, so 1 more point of damage. And then, and also I get another experience point, not that it matters. And then I'm also attacking him for 2 and immobilize, but I'm at disadvantage. And I also do the freeze thing. So I'm at disadvantage, so plus 0 or plus 1. So plus 0, so 4 points of damage and immobilize. So I guess he's dead.
No, he has 2 shields.
Oh, right, but he's immobilized and he's only got 1 hit point left. And I have to shuffle now.
You do a lot of burst damage there. That was a lot of damage. He does a lot of damage
as long as he stays alive, which... The hard part.
That's okay. Well, I mean, this is where we lose, right? Because all 3 warriors are going to kill this guy. The first Inox guard whacks on the NPC. Oh, wait. They're not attacking?
They
retaliate too. They're not attacking.
Sweet. Okay.
So they all have shield 1 now. And retaliate. Then that's that. And then the golems. The golem's gonna attack him. That golem's moving forward 1. Oh wait, it's a range attack. The golem does not need to move. The golem's gonna shoot the NPC.
Is it gonna shoot the NPC or is it gonna shoot me? Because we're equally distant.
That's true, and you have lower initiative.
Yeah.
So the golem shoots you.
Yep.
With an attack of 3, draws a 0, so 3 points, and pulls you.
And pulls me?
Uh-huh, towards him.
I don't want to be pulled.
And then also immobilizes you.
Well, I was already immobilized, so.
You stay immobilized, I guess. I don't know. It doesn't double up. This golem shoots you again. 1 doesn't need to move and shoots you and draws a minus 1. So 2 more points.
Dang, yo. I'm down to then 1 point.
The golem is going to move so that he can shoot the Mind Thief, right? Yeah.
So where is he going to move to?
Oh, the other guy's immobilized. That golem's immobilized. So cannot move. He's going to shoot. He has a range of 3. So does he shoot the Spellweaver? Because that way he won't be at disadvantage?
Yeah.
Okay. So he shoots the Spellweaver, draws a minus 1. So 2 points to Spellweaver. and pulls the spell weaver forward and immobilizes the spell weaver. Did I draw a damage card yet? Oh, missed. Never mind. You missed.
Okay.
Next is the one archer. He's got a move two, attack four, range three. So he's gonna 1, 2, 3. He can see the spell weaver, right?
Yes.
Okay, so he's not gonna move. He's just gonna shoot the spell weaver. Draws a plus zero, does 4 points to the spellweaver, who's now at four.
Okay.
Now it's the summoner's turn.
Okay, so my thorn shooter is gonna shoot that same archer that he's been shooting at for a bit now. And it's for two and poison, except he's already poisoned, so for three and poison again. 3 points, that guy is dead. 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 Okay. Now, I am immobilized. I was gonna do one thing, but I don't think it makes any sense to do it anymore because it won't be, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna attack three, range three, and immobilize the guard, I guess, that's over here. Yeah, the guard over here. So immobilize and 3 points of damage plus one, 4 points of damage and immobilize on the guard that's furthest away from me. Well, on the other side of the NPC. So he's now immobilized and I did, how many did I say? Four. 4 points of damage on him. Do they have shield or anything? They do not.
Wait. Can you back up? What? Yeah. How much damage have you done so far?
I just did 4 points of damage to this guy. That's like across the NPC from me.
Okay.
And then I also killed the archer.
Yep, I got that.
Okay. And then for my other, I don't have a summoned ally nearby, so I'm going to just whack. Who am I gonna whack? The shaman, I guess? Yeah, I'm gonna whack the shaman for two. And, ooh, heal oneself, and then whiff. So I don't get to heal oneself, I whiffed.
That's sad.
Yeah, that is sad because I'm down to one hit point with that character. But we're about to die anyway, so sad face.
Your summoner has one hit point?
Yep.
Yeah,
the double damage that was gonna make us lose that turn, and now I get to lose this turn instead.
Okay.
Oh wait, you still have
My guy.
Yeah.
The golem that's right in front of me has one hit point.
Yes.
Is there a sun thing out? No, there isn't.
No.
Okay, I'm moving two spaces here, healing you for 3 points.
Thank you.
And making a sun appear.
Cool.
And that's it.
All right.
My spellweaver is doing the long rest. Gains, how many hit points do you get for a long rest? Two? Okay, and then the NPC has to move.
Oh yeah. He's gonna go around this way. 1, 2, 3. He's just like moving away.
Is he gonna die as soon as he hits a trap?
No, he hasn't taken any damage yet.
Oh.
But it's only a matter of time. And the traps are, I think, three damage, something like that.
Okay. Oh, wait. When I had the Sunkeeper moving, I forgot to do this. Replenish your spent items. So this chainmail is back.
Okay.
You know what? I'm going to use this too. Stamina push and get these cards back. Okay. Next round. Would it be fair to say that I should just like run it as fast as I can and protect the dude or something?
I guess. I just don't see any way. I don't see any way that this is going to end well.
I mean, I have to have very low initiative so that they attack me, right? Mm-hmm. Run in their face and make them all attack me, right?
Pretty much. And I'm already there
in their face. And then you will go before him, so maybe you can block.
I'm stuck. I need to.
You're stuck.
Yeah, I'm totally stuck.
I need a low card.
Did not get enough coffee today, I guess.
Okay, I've got the Sunkeeper has 23.
Okay.
The Spellweaver has 69.
Okay. The Mind Thief has 8 and the Summoner has 32.
Okay, Mind Thief first, then the Rock Golems or Stone Golems are gonna have Retaliate. Then we're gonna go, then the other guy's gonna go. Yeah, looks okay.
Okay, so the Mind Thief is going to, what did I do? Okay. First, he's going to attack for 4. The guy next to him, 5. So that guy's dead.
Attacks Golem?
Yep. For 5. Oops. So then he moves forward 2, I guess. 1, 2. It was.
Are you grabbing loot?
Nah.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
If I survive this turn, I want to be closer so that I can run in there. So that's the Mind Thief's turn.
Okay. That guy's dead. The 2 Stone Golems don't do anything. They just retaliate up. Sunkeeper. I am moving. 1, 2. And then activating my retaliate.
Cool.
That's it. Summoner.
Okay. So first, the summoner is going to shoot that same guard that I've been shooting at. Attack of three.
Oh, wait, your what's it call it?
Oh right, moves two, one, two. Super boring. Can't reach anybody. Okay, so now I'm attacking that same guard that I attacked before.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot to shuffle my cards. Okay, so attack of three plus one, attack of four on that guy.
One, so he's down to one hit point?
Four, yep, he's down to one hit point. And then attack of one. I guess I'm gonna attack the shaman because the stone golems have retaliate. So attack of one on that shaman guy, plus one attack of two on the shaman.
Okay. One,
and that is my turn. I have to do a short rest on both of my guys here in a minute.
Okay.
Oh wait, hold on. I'm gonna recover two of my discarded cards. You know what, I'm gonna do it on both of them. Because okay. They both have that.
All right, the guards. This guy right here attacks me. An attack of three draws a plus one, so that's 4 points on me. I'm using my chainmail, so that's 3 points on me, but he gets I retaliate him for two, so he's down to seven. This guy attacks me also, draws a minus two, so does 1 point, and I'll use the chainmail, so does 0 points, and dies because I retaliate.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy now can move to where that guy was and attack me. And draws a minus one, so hits me for 2 points. Hits me for 1 point, so I'll use the chainmail again.
Okay.
So I'm at 11.
And then you retaliate for two.
Yeah, and I retaliate.
Okay.
And then the my spellweaver turn. Okay. Check out this move. I am going to jump 8 spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven, 8 to here.
Where? Between the stump and the golems?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And then I'm going to... Oh, wait, I don't have to do that. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to move to here instead. So, like next to the guy.
Okay.
And I cause a wind icon.
Sweet.
And then I'm going to attack three, range three, target three guys. Wait. 1, 2, 3. I shouldn't move there. I should move here. 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
Pick a spot.
I'm going to be here instead.
Okay.
I can target these three guys without being at disadvantage or something. Or I can target. Yeah, I'll target. I don't know. Whatever. So I'm targeting three guys. Which guy should I target?
Well, obviously the one closest to the dude. And yeah. I would say the golems, because they have retaliate, and since it will be a far, you know, we have to kill them anyway. So that way you can do damage without getting retaliated.
That's true, but the shaman's going to heal.
Oh, and how, what's their range on retaliate for the golems?
3.
Oh, never mind. Don't do that.
Yeah, never mind. I'm not doing that.
Then I would say the 2 guards and the shaman if you can.
Yeah, I'll be at disadvantage against one of the guards. That's okay. I can deal with that. Okay, so first this guy. Attack of 3. Whiffs.
Ow.
The second guy, which is the shaman, -1. So it's 2 points on the shaman.
Okay.
Not that good. And then the guy right in front of me, I have to draw twice because I'm at disadvantage. -2.
Ooh.
Or -1. It'll be the -1. So 2 points on this card.
Ooh.
That's dumb. But I do gain 3 XP.
That's good.
That was not as amazeballs as I thought it would be.
You caught up though.
And now it's the shaman's turn. The shaman's gonna move 1 space and heal 1, affecting all adjacent allies. So I think is not gonna move.
Yeah.
And just heal that 1 guard, right?
Yeah. For how many points?
1 hit point.
Okay.
Wait, that's a 6. Uh-huh. But he also blesses himself. How do we do that in this?
Bless.
Yeah. Okay, next round.
Next round indeed.
Oh, and I caused a flame to appear also. I forgot to say that.
Gosh, you just made everything appear that last turn. Okay, I guess that's what I'm doing. Oh, yes, that is totally what I'm doing. How's my health? My health is okay. If we somehow pull this out, I will be fascinated. Oh, we forgot to move the guy.
Oh yeah.
He's now next to the traps, I guess.
I guess so. He's either here or here. Where do you think he should be?
Between the stump and the, yeah. It's about to get bad. Bad.
If I did healing, would you take it?
If you what?
If I heal.
Oh, yes, my summoner needs healing. I'm down to 4 hit points.
Okay.
Of 15.
Because alternatively, I could attack.
Either way, my characters are very sad. Well, actually, my mind thief's okay because he just like hung out in the first room for a while. Lately. But my thorn shooter's still alive.
Hooray. Okay.
Yeah.
My Sunkeeper has 32. And then the other guy has 36.
Okay. My Mind Thief has 9. And my Summoner also has 32.
Okay. You're a mind thief first.
Okay. So I'm going to use my boots of striding and move. Wrong way around. Move three, one, two, three, up in this guy's face. And then I am going to, wait a second. No, I'm not. I'm not using my boots of striding. I'm going in the doorway. I lied. And then I am attacking. Actually, I guess I can go at that guy's face. I'm going to save the boots of striding. I'm going to attack four and immobilize and also cause a frozen thing. Which one should I do? The shaman?
Attack four. You might be able to kill the shaman.
Yeah, I'm going to attack four the shaman.
Okay.
And immobilize. And immobilize. Yep. Okay, so I hit him for four, so he's dead. And then that's all I can do. He's dead. With the mind thief.
Okay. The guards, they're just shielding up and they're going to have retaliation. Okay. The golems, that one golem attacks you. Ooh, okay. Draws a plus one, 6 points of damage against your summoner.
All right, I'm going to have to toss cards because I guess I'm going to have to toss this card. Shoot.
The golem takes one hit point of damage.
Wait, I can take two out of my discard, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. And the golem takes 1 point of damage?
Yep.
Okay.
And the other golem runs up to where the shaman used to be and attacks me. And draws a minus one, so that's 4 points of damage. I'll use my last chainmail thing, so that's 3 points of damage, so I'm down to eight. But then the golem takes 1 point of damage from himself and also takes 2 points of damage from my retaliate, so down to, so it gets 3 points of damage. One, two, three. Okay, now it's Sunkeeper turn.
Okay.
I'm gonna heal you for 3 points. And cause the sun to appear. Then I am going to have one adjacent ally make an attack of four. And I think that has to be your Sunkeeper.
You mean summoner?
Yeah, sorry, summoner.
Okay, it's not ranged, it's just an attack of four?
Yeah.
All right, I guess I hit the guy that's down to 10. Plus one.
Wait, he's at 11.
He's at 11?
I think so. He was at 14 and took 3 points last turn.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So then shield of two. So 3 points of damage.
That's pretty good. One, two, three. So he's at eight now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's the Sunkeeper's turn. Summoner turn.
Okay. So the summoner is going to attack three, range three, pierce three, and then use the wind for two more attacks. So attack five, range three, pierce three, but at a disadvantage. I'm going to attack that same guy. So either plus one or plus zero. So I'm going to attack him. I'm using the wind and I'm attacking him for five and I have pierce of three, so he gets all 5 points of damage.
Awesome. So he's at three now.
Yes. And then, that's the wrong one. And then I'm going to just do the same thing except I don't have five. I only have three, but I'll immobilize him. So for either I'm still at disadvantage. Oh, that doesn't count for disadvantage. So either plus one or plus zero, so three, so one more point of damage on him. And I just realized that I forgot to do my thorn shooter. So my thorn shooter moves two, one, two, and shoots at, who's lower initiative, the golem or the guard? The guard?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so he shoots at the guard that's like in between you and your, between the two you.
Yep.
For two and poison. Ooh, plus a wound. So poisoned, wounded, and 2 points of damage to that guy. Which guy is that? One. 2 points, poisoned, wounded. And
fancy that, me.
Yeah, I can't summon my skeleton because he is, because there's no room. So that is it. That's my turn. It's the best I can do.
I'm now hopeful.
Yeah, we still have two more rooms though, and I'm gonna run out of cards like pretty soon here. I have to do a short rest on both of my guys, but you still have your spell weaver, so I'm not gonna.
Yeah, so my spell weaver is gonna summon a mystic ally, so I get a summon.
Sweet.
And I'll put him, I guess, right here.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll put him right here. No, I'll put him right here. So between me and the trap.
Okay.
So he has 2 hit points, a move of 2, an attack of 3, range 2, but can't do anything this turn, right?
Yeah.
And then also attack. Geez. Attack this guy.
Okay.
With an attack of 3 plus 1. So 3 points, but plus a wound. So that guy takes 3 points of damage and has a wound. So they both have wounds now.
Sweet. So we could just leave them behind now. Except we still have those golems to deal with.
That's true, yeah. They'll eventually but just
those die. Guys will eventually just die, yeah. Because we killed the shaman that would heal them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's my turn. This guy runs through the door and all that shit. So he runs through a trap.
And takes 2 points of damage. 2 points? 2 points or 3 points?
I don't remember.
4 points? 4 points of damage.
Ew.
4 points.
Then runs through the door and then runs one more space in.
What a jerk. This guy's a jerk.
And we have 3 more guys to deal with now.
Yep.
2 more guards, except these guys are elite.
And an elite archer. I'm no longer hopeful. Oh, I'm doing my short rest.
Yeah. Elite archer.
Fine, whatever. Don't care anymore. I just don't care anymore. This is terrible.
Okay, so those 2 guards that were just spawned need to move. All they do is shield up and retaliate. Then this archer needs to move. He's not moving. He has attack of 2, range of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank God. So he doesn't do anything. Now it's the next round.
Okay.
Dude. God, this guy is so idiotic.
He is.
What if we could, like, on the very first turn, we could cripple him so he can only move like 1 space or something like that.
We're allowed to do that. If we could do that, I would do it. But I don't think, like, can we immobilize an ally? Because I want to.
Allowed to. That's really funny.
And like either he needs to start hitting things. So this is the other thing we could do if we don't clear it this time, if we decide not to take it like one level easier, we could just make it so that he does like move three, attack one or something like that. I don't know.
Or make him so that he has the same AI as other creatures. So like, except that if there's no one around, then he doesn't move. I mean, then he just moves, right? So like, he has to move to a bad guy. So that he's opening the doors and stuff like that.
So just take away his ability to open doors?
Or something like that? I don't know.
I don't know either. This is ridiculously hard. Oh my gosh, I can hear
it. I agree. This is stupid.
He just like left us all behind to get throttled. This is the worst rescue ever. Even if we just gave him the like wow AI, where like when bad guys show up, he just stops. Like he only moves forward if there's no bad guys. Which would be WoW AI.
Okay. My Spellweaver has 21.
Okay.
And my Sunkeeper has 56.
Okay. My Mind Thief has 8 and my Summoner has 32.
Okay, your Mind Thief first.
Okay. So my Mind Thief is gonna start off by refreshing the winter and getting one of, let's do that.
Refreshing what?
And winter and is gonna attack for, only on melee attacks. Attack for one and stun, which guy makes the most sense? One of these stone golems.
Okay.
Well, which is hitting harder?
The stone golem is going to attack for 4. The two guards are attacking at 3, but they're going to attack with poison.
Okay.
Go for a guard, I'd say.
Go for a guard?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. So I guess I'll just hit this guard that's like straight in front of me and poisoned.
Okay.
So that's actually 2 and stun. Minus 1. 1 and stun. Oh, but he's poisoned. No, that was what that was. Never mind. Okay, so minus 1, and now he's also stunned. And then that was the bottom right. Okay, and then I'm going to attack 2, range 4, and immobilize the other guy, I guess. I don't know what makes the most sense. Should I just hit that guy again? Because he might die, but then I wasted my stun.
Yeah, attack the guy, attack the other guard, I guess.
Okay, so I'm gonna attack the other guard for 2 and immobilize for 2 and immobilize. So he's down to 2 and he's also immobilized now. And that is my Mind Thief's turn. Oh, I forgot to spawn these other dudes.
Okay, both these guards take 1 point of damage.
Yes.
That guy loses his stun, so that's his turn. This guy loses his immobilize. But he shields up and attacks for 3. He attacks me for 3 points and a poison. attacks me plus zero. So he attacks me for 3 points and a poison. So I'm now poisoned and I have 5 hit points.
Ugh. Shoot.
Poison.
I did what I could.
Yeah. What's going to happen here? Everything went gray. the Spellweaver. There we go. Oh, wait, the other two guards. So they don't move. They just shield up. So they don't do anything.
Okay.
The Spellweaver. Shit, how many hit points do you have?
My summoner has 7 and my mind thief also has 7. So we're okay.
Oh, wait a second. The guy who hit me is dead because I have retaliate.
Oh, sweet. Take that. Ooh, so now that's like a double loop sitting there.
Yeah. Okay, now the Spellweaver. How much? I forgot already. How many hit points you said you had?
7 on both. So if you need to heal yourself, heal yourself.
Yeah, I'm healing the Sun Keeper for 4 points of damage, or 4 points. Okay. Heal.
Nope, just unpoisoned.
Oh shit. So for nothing, he's just not poisoned anymore.
Yep.
Terrible. It's such a waste of a thingamabobber. Okay. And I am recovering all my lost cards.
Cool.
And then also making the knight element appear.
Sweet.
So that's the Spellweaver's turn. Now it's the summoner's turn.
Okay. So first I'm recovering 4 lost cards. 1, 2, wait, which ones do I want? 1, 2, 3. Four, you can stay in there and have a friend. And then I am attacking 3, range 3, pierce 3. I guess this one that's only got 2 hit points, the stone golem that's only got 2 hit points, plus 1, so 4, he's dead.
Very much.
Now there's a double loot there too, and that is my turn. Oh wait, I forgot to do my thorn shooter. My thorn shooter shoots this guy that's poisoned and wounded and all of those things for 2. Heal oneself doesn't matter, plus 0. That guy is very dead as well. Bye-bye, you dead.
Amazing. Now we just have to run over here somehow. Like, come back, you idiot.
Oh wait, what did your guy do? What did this guy do?
Oh shit, you're right. I forgot to move him. He has a range of 2, so he probably didn't move. He would have shot this guy.
And what would he have done? Because maybe I just wasted a...
Well, then your shooter would have come forward and shot the golem instead.
Yeah, right. So we need
my guy would have hit him for 4 points of damage. So he would have died. So your shooter instead moved forward and shot the golem instead. I guess right there. Shot the
golem instead for 2 and poison. He would have just been poisoned though because he's got a shield. So now that golem is poisoned.
Okay.
And you know what? I just realized I am also going to summon my skeleton. So the skeleton guy is going to go like right here next to the golem. Oh wait, has the golem gone yet?
No.
Never mind. I'm not doing that. I lied. I'm saving my skeleton for next turn because he will die immediately.
Yeah. Okay, so now it's the golem's turn. He's poisoned. He has move 3, but he doesn't need to move. He just attacks you for 4 points, right?
Yeah.
Gets plus 1. 5 points.
I am down to 2 points.
Eesh. Okay, Sunkeeper.
You better run.
Yeah, I better run. Okay, I'm going to move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's as far as I can get.
Oh, you made him go through a different trap than I did.
That's as far as I can get.
Can you heal him? He's down to 4 points.
I cannot heal him. I had an attack that I can't use. It's okay. Just sad all around.
That is sad all around.
Okay, the archer. Attack 4, range 3. No, range 5.
Oh no, he can hit the guy.
3, 4, 5. Oh no! It might end right here. The archer draws a whiff.
It's gonna end next turn though, because this guy's about to walk straight into these guards.
Yeah, all right. So this guy goes 3 spaces. 1, 2, 3.
Maybe, yeah, right.
Maybe he's next to just one of them.
No, I don't think he is, because wasn't he in this corner?
He was right here.
Okay, you had him on that side. All right.
Doesn't matter. I mean, but he moves.
No, he's going in between the two of them no matter what, because he moves 3 spaces.
No, but it's not any closer.
Uh-huh.
No, it isn't.
1, 2. So you think he only does 2 spaces?
Yeah. Because both of these hexes are equidistant to this door.
I guess that's true. All right. I don't believe it, but because he's an idiot. There's no way he wouldn't go in between the two guards because he's an idiot.
Fine. We'll move him between the two guards. In line with we have to keep his character consistent.
Yes, and that is his character. So, ugh. All right, I guess next turn?
Yep. Maybe I can get there in time. No, I really think he would only move 2, because then I can move here and distract those 2 guards.
But that's not his personality. His personality is not to be helpful.
But he goes, oh, okay, what does the rule book say? Does it say he moves 3, or does it say he moves?
It says move 3 towards the shaman.
Yeah, he doesn't need to move. It doesn't get him any closer to the shaman.
Okay. I'm not sure I buy that his personality would allow that, but that's okay.
But when it's ambiguous, we decide in our favor.
That's true.
In this way, I can move. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I can move there. Okay. I mean, this might not matter. He's going to die anyways, probably.
I'm probably going to die this round, too. Unless I'm extremely lucky, at least one of my dudes is going down. Which I guess actually, never mind. I'm going to change what I'm doing so that I have a better chance of survival.
Okay.
not there, but it was Rudolph, and it was so rapidly read. Reading Richard's book, Angel of Steel, he mentioned how I think
how many points do you have? We kind of need to heal him, right?
I am down to 2 hit points on my summoner.
Okay.
I still have 7 on my other guy.
I have, 91 on my Spellweaver and 29 on my Sunkeeper.
All right, I have 11 on my Mind Thief and 13 on my Summoner.
Wow, fast guys. All right, your Mind Thief first.
Okay, Mind Thief is moving 2, 1, 2 onto that giant pile of loot. And is healing 2, so is now up to full health. And okay. Then is attack 2, wait, let me see. Attack 3 and 4, 5 because it's a melee attack. So attack of 5 on the golem. Plus 0, so attack of 3, I guess, since he's got 2 shield.
But the golem is poisoned.
Oh, okay, right. So then attack of 4. And then I'm also attacking 3 on the golem again. Plus 2, attack of 5, plus he's poisoned, attack of 6, minus 2, so another 4 points of damage. 4.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's my turn for him. And then is it the summoner's turn next?
Yep.
Okay, so the thorn shooter shoots the golem for 2 and poison again, plus 1 for 3 and poison again. So he's 4.
Yeah.
Minus 2, so 2 points of damage.
Wait.
And
Wait. You did 3 and 4 minus 2. Yeah, okay. 2 points of damage. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So he's at 3.
Yeah, that's what I have too. Okay. And now my summoner is going to run away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I guess, over here. And then is gonna summon a slime spirit. To like right behind you, I guess.
Okay.
Where am I? And that is my turn. Oops, that's not correct. Go away.
Oh, wait. I have no idea, right. Okay.
1.
My turn?
Okay. Yes, your turn now.
I am moving this guy 1, 2, 3, 4, and then attacking this guy for 2 plus 1 for 3 points and a stun.
Which guy?
This guy who's next to an NPC.
Okay. So 3 points and a stun?
Yep.
Sweet.
Which means he can't retaliate me, right? Because he's stunned. Hopefully.
Let me double check that stun means cannot do anything but rest. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's that Sunkeeper's turn. Okay, so then that guy becomes unstunned. And the other guy attacks me for 4. Draws a plus 1. Attacks me for 5. And I have to take it, and ooh, shit, that puts me down at 0. I have to lose a card. Is it random which card you use, lose, or do you get to choose?
I chose. I don't know if that's true, but that's what I did. I think that's how we've been playing the whole time, is that you get to choose if you're losing a card for that. Give me 3 seconds. I'm going to grab a drink of water.
To retaliate.
Okay, I'm back. What happened?
Yimmy gets 2 damage from retaliate. So he's down to 10.
Okay.
Okay. This archer. Attack 2, range 4. Target 2?
Oh no, it's going to target both of you.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Okay, it's attack of 2?
Mm-hmm.
He can, as long as it's not a times 2, he can take it.
Okay, so first he attacks me, I guess. Minus 1, so attack of 1 point. Shit. Oh yeah, that's good. I'm down to 4. Mm-hmm. And then the other guy, he attacks, it's a times 2.
It is. Oh no. He just died. Death.
What are the chances? No.
I'm so tired of this scenario.
Damn it, and I was going to get on the chest this time.
This is the worst scenario. This is just... Does it end
immediately, or do we get to finish out the round?
I don't think we get to finish out the round.
Yeah, okay.
Sad. That's just sad. This is sad. I mean, I was about to die anyway. I was about to have major issues anyway, because I was running out of cards, but still, I was not careful with cards because I was so sure we were dying like 3 other times. So I just was like blowing lost cards.
Yeah, I know. This scenario is ridiculous. I'm gonna start reading threads about it. I think there might be some good strategy guides or something.
I looked at them and I didn't look at them very hard, I will admit that, but I looked at them and I didn't see anything obvious that we weren't doing, kind of thing. So I don't know.
Wow.
Maybe we're just the wrong kind of characters. We need to like have that brute going so that he can just rush in and pull all the aggro and stab everybody in the face.
I guess so.
They're so okay. No offense to anybody who plays a brute, but I don't like tanking. It's not my fave. And I did not manage to do, I failed on both of mine, even though it didn't matter anyway.
Tanking only works if they have the lowest initiative. Your mind thief kept drawing so much of the attention that otherwise I would have been tanking a lot, I feel like.
Yeah, well, he doesn't have a lot of late cards. And frankly, I didn't get to use about half of his really good things. He's like, some of the stuff that seems like it would be really awesome to use is a lost card. So like there's one that's, where did it go? This one, it's attack 4, range 4, heal 4 self, and it's a lost card. So I kept not playing it because I was like, I'm gonna need this later, I think.
because he's only got 10 cards. The summoner's only got 9 cards. Your spellkeeper's only got 8 cards.
Yeah.
It's just generally a hot mess.
This is a very difficult scenario.
Yeah.
Well, we gained some XP.
We did gain some XP. I gained quite a bit of XP. Oh no, my summoner did not do such a hot job with the XP. How close was I to XP, to moving up? I needed 8 more XP for my summoner to level up and get another like higher level card. Sad. Sad. Because there's not an XP we didn't finish it. There's not an XP multiplier. I think we should take it down a level and go back to just playing with our 2 guys.
Because my guy leveled up. Yeah, you're right. Maybe we should. But I also leveled up, so maybe that'll help.
Your Sunkeeper leveled up?
Uh-huh.
Cool.
Like, exactly. I'll deal with that later. And then this other guy got 4 points. And how much gold is each of these things worth?
3. Sorry, little mind thief guy. I think you're going back in the box.
I thought he was pretty awesome. I mean, he did a lot of damage.
It's just hard keeping him alive.
Yeah.
Which is like half the point of the characters. You're supposed to be quick and like zoom in and out and whack things and control them to whack each other and things like that. I did actually read the thing about it. The problem is that I didn't think about that on those first couple of turns. I wasn't thinking about the fact that he was immediately going to take all the damage. Whoops. He's just pretty squishy. He's squishier than my summoner. Weird, but whatever. Maybe I'll keep playing him, maybe not. I need that demolitionist from Jaws of the Lion is what I need. That dude is powerful.
Yeah.
Oh, but I can go shopping for more stuff. Let me see. 13 gold. I don't know if that's all that. Is there anything useful? Maybe I could get a heal potion.
Tough. Okay, tune in next time as we try this freaking again.
No, tired of this. Okay, yay. See you next time, everyone. Every nobody.
Yeah. I will stop recording.